Okay, so we have determined our random location in our 10 by 10 meter plot. And what we want to do now is take 3 soil samples around this random location. So you take 2 of these wooden 1 meter rulers and you lay them out at 90 degrees to each other. And then we would take 3 soil samples, 1 from each corner of the triangle. So the way that we take a soil sample is using this piece of equipment here, which is the soil auger. There are 2 parts to the soil auger. There's the pointy end, the business end, so this is where you actually collect the sample. And then there is the driving end, and it's all human power. This is not a drill rig. You don't just plug it into the ground and start turning and keep on going. There's a technique to successful augering. What you want to do is auger down until you have enough soil to fill up this part of the auger, fill up the auger spoon. Then you pull it out, you lay it down, and then you go back into the hole and keep going, and you eventually lay out a nice line of soil and you'll see the soil profiles. So this area here has been pretty well trampled down. What you want to do before you start augering is actually clear out the soil a little bit. You want to get rid of all of this grassy material here and actually start augering directly into the soil. So does anybody want to volunteer to be my augerer? Okay. So start it like this.
Okay.
Push and turn. And it's a bit difficult to get started. I find it challenging because I'm short, so getting the getting enough pressure. Another couple of turns. Okay, so now the spoon is full. If you pull it up, just pull it directly out of the hole. And what we're gonna do is lay it down and push it out of the spoon. So you can see we've got the surface material, we've got some nice dark soil here, and we've got our first horizon. So go back down the hole, keep turning. And once it's full again, it's probably pretty good, pull it out and then lay it down so that what you're giving is a line. So this is the top, this is the next layer. And you can already see that we've got a slight change in color here where we're hitting the next horizon.
All that dark stuff is topsoil, right?
Yep, that's all. It's all the
really
A horizon.
Thick topsoil, isn't it?
It is. And the reason that it's so thick is that this used to be an alfalfa field, so it was plowed in every year. So keep going. We'll get at least another 1, maybe 2. See how many horizons we can find. You can see here that we've well and truly gotten into the next horizon. So maybe 1 more sample. And it is possible when you're augering that you might hit the water table. Probably won't here today. That's okay. Just pull it out of your face. Okay, there we go. Okay, perfect. So what you can see here is is a soil profile. This one is not particularly clear, but if you have a look at this dark material, you've got an A horizon to about here. There's a little bit of B. This orangey material in here is B. All of this stuff here, that's sort of kind of a reddish brown color. That's because of the addition of iron into the soil. And then this material here, this sort of very light colored, dense clay rich material, is the sea horizon. This is actually the glacial till that underlies the campus here. So once you've laid out your soil, you take the meter ruler, and it's got inches on one side, it's got centimeters and meters on the other. It is the 21st century, so we want to use the metric side. You want to lay that down, and you want to measure the depth to your different horizons. So here, the A horizon ends at about 35 centimeters. And then we've probably got about maybe 10 centimeters of the B. It's a little bit challenging to see. And then from 45 centimeters downwards, we're into the sea horizon.